Welcome to My Team. Here, you'll experience the world of Formula One not only as a driver, but as the owner of a brand new F1 team. First things first, let's choose your character. Great. Now, let's set up some of the key details of your new team. We'll start with an easy one. What name would you like to give the team? Nice. Now, some kind of income stream is critical, so we need to sign a primary sponsor. Our primary sponsor will pay a signing bonus to the team up front. This is vital to cover the early investments we need to make. They will also provide valuable weekly income for us. Each sponsor has a goal that they want the team to achieve. If we hit that goal, the sponsor will pay us an additional goal bonus. Fantastic! Now we've got a budget to work with. Our car won't be going anywhere fast without a power unit. So let's sign a power unit supplier now. We need both performance and durability from our power unit, but we also need to balance the books. We're going to have a lot of other areas to invest our cash into. Key partners for our team now, but we still need a teammate for you. These are the drivers available to be your first teammate. They all have their own strengths and weaknesses, so consider everything when deciding who to hire. Drivers earn acclaim based on their performances. When a driver earns enough acclaim, they will level up. The higher a driver's level, the more acclaim they'll earn for their current team. And remember, the faster the team levels up, the faster our income will increase. The higher a driver's experience, the more resource points are earned to spend on vehicle upgrades. Racecraft is the driver's skill to effectively complete overtakes when opportunities arise. Awareness shows the driver's ability to avoid errors and incidents. Pace describes the driver's ability to set competitive lap times. Rating is a summary of the driver's overall skill level.
Looks like we can't afford this power unit supplier and teammate. Let's go back into one of those and sign someone cheaper. Or try and find a sponsor who pays more up front to offset the cost.
Some sponsors offer a larger signing bonus up front. Some offer more weekly income. The better we perform, the more our level will go up as the team gains more acclaim. Doing this will increase the income from our sponsors.
Like we can't afford this power unit supplier and teammate. Let's go back into one of those and sign someone cheaper. Or try and find a sponsor who pays more up front to offset the cost.
Obviously, the better the performance and durability, the better. But be careful.
Looks like we can afford this power unit supplier and teammate. Go ahead and confirm if you're happy. Here are the drivers interested in joining our team. look at their stats, and pick someone you think looks like we can afford this power unit supplier and teammate. Go ahead and confirm if you're happy. Let's select or edit the livery we'll be running this season. We can add more sponsors to the car as we sign them throughout the year. And don't worry, we can edit our look at any time from HQ. need a badge for our team branding. Select an existing badge, edit it, or create one from scratch. Last but not least, we need to pick team colours for the rest of our branding. You'll see these colours throughout HQ. that's everything we need. You can go back and edit anything we've done so far, and...
Okay, we're live in 5, 4, 3.
Hello folks, and welcome to the HQ of Formula One's newest team. We've been invited backstage to gain an exclusive insight into what could be one of the most exciting entries in the sport for many years. Now, we've seen a number of new teams enter the sport over the last decade, amongst their number Manor, Caterham, HRT, and of course Haas. And while some have proved to be successful, others have morphed into different teams, and some have disappeared completely. What marks this team out, though, as being something different is that its owner is also its driver. Now, there's a rich history of that in Formula One too. Sir Jack Brabham, John Surtees, Graham Hill, and Bruce McLaren all drove their own cars in the sport, but it has become increasingly rare in recent years. What's very special about this team, though, is that while the team itself is new to Formula One, so too is its driver and owner.
Whatever happens this season, you've already made the history books. Tell me, do you feel up to the mammoth task of both managing and driving for a Formula One team? Every team needs two drivers. But what was it that drew you to your teammates. No one aims to finish bottom of the table. Who's the team you're aiming to beat? How are you expecting the car to feel out on track? The other teams now have years of experience, both on and off the track. How are you planning to catch up to them? Overtaking is a key part of this sport. How have you ensured that your car can take advantage of each opportunity that comes your way? And finally, which of your new departments are you most proud of? Well, that's about all we've got time for here. We will see how this fledgling team fares in its first Grand Prix.
Okay, great. Thank you. That's a wrap.
Great interview, boss. You nailed exactly what the team's been working on. When you've got time, check the R&D tree to see current progress and where we think there's room for more. And while you're at it, why not take a stroll around HQ and check on how the team's doing? This is where you can view our current facilities and the effects they're having on the business. You can also invest some of our cash into upgrades for these facilities. It's important to use the time between races to the fullest extent, and that's where these activities come in. Manage everyone's time as efficiently as possible to maximize the team's performance.
morning, boss. Jeff here. Thanks again for bringing me on board. You've found a lot of talented people for this team. I can't wait to see what we can accomplish. Our journey to the Constructors' Championship starts here today, and the car is ready to head out whenever you are.
In the unforgiving world of Formula One, free...
There's just 5% of our initial fuel load left over. 5%. A bit like a rubber out on track. Try to take it easy for a couple of laps. DRS zone is coming up. Get ready to open it. Distance is on your MFD. Stuff. You've pretty much... I know it's tempting to focus entirely on the race, but we should put a bit of time aside to run the qualifying sim program. Try to run it before the end of FP3 if you can. Okay. That wasn't much help to us. We need it again, I'm afraid. Fuel, box in the next two laps, please. Come in this lap, please. Box this lap. Engine off, engine off.
And with all the cars now over the line, let's see our top three again. Hamilton, Hunt, and Max Verstappen. What an incredible practice session. The fun doesn't stop here, though. Join us again as the rest of the weekend unfolds.
It's pretty quiet out on track. We should consider getting out there. Okay, we'll alter the setup of the car. Less than a lap of fuel now. The tank is empty. So far, our fastest lap is a 1 minute 23.1. We're 22nd in the speed trap, 199.1 miles per hour. Everyone ready? Okay, let's go.
With qualifying finished, it's time to remind ourselves of our top three.
Bottas,
Hamilton,
and Hunt.
Goodbye for now then, but we're really just getting started. Make sure to join us again for Lights Out tomorrow.
I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
Months of rumour and speculation all come to an end today as we return to Melbourne for the opening race of what promises to be an enthralling season. Welcome along then to the Australian Grand Prix. The Melbourne circuit is certainly one that needs to be taken seriously. Its combination of slippery surfaces and difficult corners make it a tricky track when it comes to overtakes. Drivers find it hard to pass and will need to take full advantage of those DRS zones if they want to have any hope of breaking through. Can Mercedes start with victory in their bid to win a seventh consecutive constructors' title? Could Ferrari or Red Bull establish an advantage early on? And with 22 cars on the grid, how quickly can the new team find their footing? Well, it's great to be back, Anthony Davidson. We've got a lot to talk about this year.
That's right, Crofty. It felt like a long winter, but it's good to finally be back. I have to think the usual suspects will battle it out at the front, but there are always going to be some teething problems early on in the season, so whoever can keep on top of their issues will have the advantage today.
As I mentioned earlier, we're up to 11 teams this season, with a new entry run by, well, of all things, an owner-driver. That's something we haven't seen in this sport since Hector Rabach over four decades ago. So how are they looking so far?
It's hard to imagine how a small operation like that could survive in the ruthless world of Formula One. And yet, here they are, first ever race, looking surprisingly strong. But there are no points for qualifying. Let's see how they fare in the Grand Prix proper.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Good job yesterday from Valtteri Bottas. The Finn starts from pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Hunt, Norris, Sebastian Vettel, and Verstappen, Sainz, Perez, Leclerc, and Alexander Albon, Ricciardo, Stroll, Esteban Ocon, and Kvyat, Gasly, Magnussen, Romain Grosjean, and Antonio Giovinazzi, Gilel, Russell, Raikkonen, and Nicholas Latifi. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today?
Okay, our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of the lap. Radar is clear. Weather is looking good for now. rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. That's a decent start. Good job. DRS is being enabled this lap. We can use DRS when you are within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. You're increasing the gap on the car behind by 5/10 per lap. Flag. Be aware, there's an incident in the next part of the track. No overtaking through the yellow flags. Okay, clear. approaching the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. Issues with tire wear for now. Keep taking care of them. Pit window open. Let's box this lap. Stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track. Go, go now, go. Exit now. We're racing on the exit. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Sean is in the pits. Sean in the pits. Advise moving to mix 2, fuel to mix 2. We have a gap of around 10 seconds until you reach the next car. Is gaining on you by 5/10 a lap. has 5 laps of fuel remaining. So we've been looking at the damage, and we think you should be okay to continue. It'll cost us a little bit of time, but we're nearly at the end of the race. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. Take it easy on the car. We can't sustain this level of damage. Two laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap. Final lap of the race. We're leading our teammate by 30.8 seconds. Okay, you need to give that position. Engine mode much longer. We're about a lap over target. Drop down to mix too soon. Top job, my friend, top job. I was a bit worried about this one at the start of the weekend, but you've pulled through. Thank you.
So Mercedes have won it, and what a great race it was. Talk to me, Ant. What was it that set them apart from the competition today?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it. So then, it's good to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Valtteri Bottas takes the top spot. He's our new Drivers' Championship leader after today.